Hello, everyone. Sese here with more Final Fantasy XI. Joining me is, of course, Silly. Joining me is, of course, Miro. We are currently with Anime Gamer, who has finally decided to use his other character. As you can see, they are already stronger than us.
Oh, yeah.
We did. Howard, check this out. Check this out. This is amazing. I have a 119 hat, 119 gloves, pants, and shoes. Now I gotta figure out how to get accuracy in other ways because I'm still way below the accuracy cap. However, I discovered that Joachim will increase our accuracy, so we're going to do that. That said, today we're gonna head over to Commier Drifts, Biovac 4. We're gonna start our quest where we left off, where we could not break down those Amaranth walls. The good thing is, now we can.
That's indeed true. So where do we go for that? We're going to the
waypoint.
Same place as yesterday, basically, I think.
Yep, and we're gonna follow the guide around because I don't know how to get around otherwise.
Let's do it.
But yeah, so Joachim can increase our accuracy a decent amount so that we should be at least over 900 when we use him. So, yeah, unfortunately, right. Joachim me. Will be taking the place of Olmia until we get accuracy.
No.
Alright, so we want to mount up. We are going to be using War Machine.
War Machine.
Iron Patriot sounds better. Anime Gamer warped right here, though, because they already have the warp point.
What?
There's a warp point to the,
It's cheating.
To the enigmatic device, but we never got it.
It's cheating.
It is. That's alright, though, we can just ride our mounts there. Oh, yeah, suck this ice walls up again. Okay. Yeah, I know we strayed too far, but we can't do that one yet. It's funny, Silly and I can break down these walls that we couldn't break down last week in Outer Razrakazra, or whatever the fuck that place is called. But we cannot break down the ice in this area because we never did the quest for it. We'll get around to that eventually, I'm sure. Watch us get blocked by it later. But that's why we got Biovac 4, though, is so that we can skip those.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, afflicted with frost. Alright.
Damn. I didn't get afflicted with frost.
Because I'm ahead of you and better than you. The game was like, I had to nerf Mira.
Well, that makes sense.
Alright, so we gotta click on this if you recall. We're heading back in. Okay. Ah, yes, that's right. Ogami likes the music here, and so did we. So let me pull up my guide to get through this place. Alright. So we're gonna go to L8 and descend the roots. That is just south of us, that's right. Where is Anime Gamer though?
The magic Anime Gamer. Alright.
So I remember we were actually able to kill the ones here, but I'll still summon Joachim so we can just be using him.
My dagger skill is 424.
Oh, Vice is up in that corner. Alright, let's go up there. Might as well get it while we're here. Right, now, if we
I
cook
thought
this,
the trusts take a really strange, like, path.
Yeah.
So we're clicking this thing.
Yeah. So I'm not exactly sure where we have to go. So we're on map 2 right now, I guess. No, we're on map 1. That leads us to L8. Okay, which I'm not sure where that leads us over here. Pretty sure we have to. Let anime gamer lead us, I guess. I'm not sure if we can just cut through to various areas or not. Turns here.
I just realized that you may not on your windows have reactive sizing, and so that's probably why I can't see what people are saying at the time. But yeah,
that's possible. Do we want to go through here, or okay, we have to follow the same path as last time. Okay, I know where we're going then. Back this way. If we follow the same path as last time, unfortunately, it'll take a little bit to get there, but we can bypass a step or two in that we just don't have to pick up the scales this time. We should already have those, I think. Yes, Moontouch Scale and Starblast Scale, we got those. Heading towards L8, which should be right over here, and we'll descend these roots. Still behind me, Philly?
Yeah. Excellent. I'm just fiddling with my settings to see what I can do to make my look even better than it is. Probably nothing.
I think mine looks pretty snazzy so far.
Yeah.
I gotta open up my research gacha so that it. There we go. There we go. Perfect. We gotta go around the other side, that's right. Climb down the roots. Alright, so from here, destroy the Amaranth barriers at J10. Okay, so J10 is right here. We gotta go west. Okay. So if there's a barrier here, we break it down. If there's nothing here, we're good. There are some bristle hair bats, though. Ah, there's a barrier. We have to fight our first one. This one wasn't here last time we came through, so.
Was this the one we did for the quest, though?
We were able to get through because someone had already broken it down. I suppose we could also invest in accuracy food if we really need it. Well, with Joachim, it seems to have gone up in our accuracy, but then again, we weren't having too much trouble with these last week. I only seem to have a minor delay now with attacking, so.
I'm checking some of my abilities here.
Plus, Joachim will also cast heals too, so. Oh, I guess I'm fighting this one. Alright. I'm just humble. Oh, you're not gonna kill you. There you go. Enjoy your attack up. Aw, man, Valeno just did 1,725 damage. I guess I can flip.
Look how fast I'm attacking.
Hey, you're exceeding even my level of attack speed. That's ridiculous.
I have 3,000 DP, okay.
I'm still hitting pretty fast, but I'm not, kick attacking much. Hang on, let me add a kick attack.
Have you added?
Oh, I can modify how often I kick by using footwork.
Oh.
It increases the, There we go. And Valinor, I'll finish this it off. Oh, no, I want to target him right here. I want to attack him. Amaranth barrier. Look at this. We can finally tear down this wall. Reigen would be proud.
That's right.
I'm not entirely certain making Reigen proud is a good thing, but there you go. Right, and we have to head over to. Pretty sure it's this way we gotta go, but I'll check in a sec. Maybe not. No, that's right. This is where we had to go all the way around. Okay, so we broke the H10. Little map to ride the elevator at H9. Oh wait, no, we should go this way. Okay, and because of the path turret. That's right. It wasn't until later that happens. Ride the elevator at H9. This is like just a lot of reused rooms and textures stuck together, which is cool because like I like the architecture design, but kind of sad that it's the same room over and over again. It's very much like Tulia and Alteo, if you remember those areas. All right, on map one, go to I-11 and Y-Skin. Okay, so. We gotta go to I-11 and then we gotta go to C-7.
Going up.
Okay. Could just skip to C-7 though, possibly, so let's go this way. We don't need to go to the I-11, that's where the, okay, so we're gonna have to go around the other way. That is a dead end.
Greetings.
Hello, fancy meeting you here. Alright.
Fight like all of these when we came in here.
Yeah, we did.
Can we successfully navigate beyond them? Maybe. I love the like walk forwards and spin around and start not walking forward. I do that.
Okay, I don't remember if this is the dead end or not. I'm pretty sure this was. Yeah, dead end. Okay. So we're gonna go back down this way and go across the room and around. I remember one of these paths was really long. Oh, somebody got something.
No.
What do we have? Bring it over here. Or no. Oh, think I put an end to this fight almost. I got everything. Oh man, Ice Spikes is doing some damage now. Oh, Mario, dude, what are you doing? Come on. Keep us at full HP, buddy. Silly is paralyzed.
It's fixing your macros because apparently you can't use a macro that's like the second line of the macro.
I was doing D&D with Frosty and them on Tuesday.
Oh, yeah. What do you play?
D&D.
No, what do you play as?
Oh, I am a gnome mage, illusionist mage.
Excellent.
So he had made us do this thing called that he called the Grand Melee. Just this big arena that had all these random effects that occurred every round. Uh-huh. And at the final round, it was just us five players left. And
fighting
so
each other.
He had us all fighting each other. And Magic Missile has a 120 yard radius. So my two of the members attack each other, and one of them has like two health left.
So you just take him out.
So I turn around.
Always hits.
I turn around and Magic Missile across the arena, and he's like, "Fuck you!" I'm like, "I'm sorry, I had to steal that kill." And then a meteor comes down and kills my character.
Oh, why'd the meteor kill you?
Because that was only the effects of the arena that he rolled.
Oh, I see. Interesting.
Yeah, so my character like magic missiles him, and then he meteors, and he's like, "Fuck you!" Middle finger, and he goes flying away. Oh, and as I died, I cast Prestidigitation. The GM let me cast Prestidigitation on one of my nearby party members.
Excellent.
You know what that does?
No.
It lets me change the effect of something, so I was able to change the effect of my friend's pants to look like they were shit, that he had shit in them. As I died. He also had this, like, black sphere that went around the arena, and if it, every round it would move a certain direction that he set up via a table. And it kept staying around our friend, Mark. For some reason, the entire time, it would just hang out around his character. So, and if it went over your character, it hit you for pretty high damage. So, I decided that in future games, I'm just going to summon a minor illusion of this black sphere and have it chase him around. Which, I need your help with ideas for that, but I'll talk to you about it later.
Yeah, you should definitely do that. Okay. Always take every opportunity to terrify your teammates.
We had to infiltrate this village of rat people, but he's a tiefling. They look like demons. But we dared him to dress up like a rat and try to infiltrate. And his character has no charisma, so he lost the role to resist the suggestion.
Oh no. What is it? How much charisma does he have? Zero?
Like
no.
Eight.
Oh, I see.
And the person trying to convince him had like 18. So he,
don't know.
He dresses like up like a rat, and they see through it instantly. All right, we're gonna skip this because I don't really care about it. And then he decides that he's gonna go stand at the street where all the weird things are happening, and he just stands in the open with a cheese wheel pretending to be a rat. Mark's very new and doesn't realize that fighters are not the best for subterfuge.
Is a tiefling fighter?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Because Tom let them play whatever anybody wanted to play, and he wanted to play a tiefling.
Well, tiefling is fine, but it just seems like a strange race to choose to be a fighter.
Yeah.
That's like how you made me be one of those godborn people who like had like plus dex and plus int, and then I was a barbarian.
Oh man, that guy was so upset.
That guy was so mad.
Hello, Silkykins. How you doing, Silky Kittens? Long time no see. Where have you been?
Yeah, what the hell?
Anyway, that guy, he was so angry that I made this character that wasn't designed specifically to play the game. And I was like, I've never played the game before, and I was given the choice. Like, what do you expect?
Like, if I would have, if I actually was playing the game for real, for serious, I would have, like, made a character that made sense. But
yeah.
What's the point of that? I mean, on easy, you can kind of get away with whatever you want, but
it looks like a
also,
fun game.
Yeah, it is. I haven't gotten much farther than that, actually, ever.
You should stream
I've
that.
Gotten into the next town and, like, done some of the opening quest lines to that, but, like, it's very slow moving, so
yeah.
If I don't have a lot of time to play it, it's, like, difficult. Iso really loves that game.
I know, he messaged me and he was just like, no, why are you doing this to his character?
Did he?
Yeah.
That's amazing. Do I just walk onto it and it works? Or...
I'm entirely certain.
Because I can't find a thing to click.
Neither can I.
So we don't need this? Okay. And anime gamer's like, you noobs.
Is it the same pathway?
Alright, Silky Kittens, what do you play in D&D? And I'll tell you all what I'm going to be playing when I play.
Alright, we're going to E8 now. Doing a pilot exam for English. Ah, yes. Oh, hanging out with your friends is definitely more important than anything else. I agree. Well, other than work and school.
No, it's more important than work and school, too.
Well, I mean, with me, I can hang out with my friends during work and school, but I don't go to school anymore, so. I'm all done the school things.
Dragonborn monk. Monk seems like it could be cool.
Ah, Monk was a lot of fun when I played it as mine. I was, I don't know the schools of Monk, so. I was a frog.
Oh, it's like a caster, right?
Paladin?
Sort of. No, like, element way. The elements is, like, you get, like, certain, like, you basically, if I remember, you get, like, certain spells that are, like, represented in a monk way, but they're like you get like additional spells from like different schools of magic. But
yeah.
They're like monk. Like,
oh, that's right. Like, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Okay, we gotta go to the elevator at H8.
That's pretty sweet. I'm gonna be a Circle of the Land druid because I'm a loser and original, and I'm gonna be a wood elf because wood elves can hide behind snowflakes.
I was, a frog monk.
Excellent. That's
and
the way it should be.
My GM gave me the ability to puff up like a frog and get extra AC if I lose my round.
Oh, so like it's like
a defensive move.
You can't attack, but you can be defensive. That's interesting.
Yeah, but I was this fist blade that gave me this ability to make my fists count as both magical and physical damage.
Excellent.
That was pretty cool. They weren't magical damage, but for the purpose of anything that was immune to physical, they were magical type.
Yeah, like if like Druid of the Moon gets that later on with their wild shapes.
Yeah.
Their attacks count as like magic for the purpose of resistance if the target's immune to physical.
And Monk also gets this ability at like level 18 or something where you don't have to eat food anymore.
It's almost as cool as the Archdruid thing, which is you get to live forever. You just become an Archdruid and you just no longer die, I think. Or you no longer age, at least.
That's
what Monk gets, timeless body, right?
Yeah.
It's like you never age, but you can die of old age.
Yeah, it's weird.
Doesn't make any sense to me. Like, I understand the concept of, like, magic is preserving, or, like, your techniques are preserving your body, but do they just eventually give out and then you die?
There's like Sonata.
Your body, Like, if your body is functioning normally, it should continue to function normally if it's not decaying, right?
Oh, speaking of which, scientists recently successfully reversed the DNA degradation in rats. What that means is they will live longer.
So they discovered the Philosopher's Stone?
Essentially, you'd think.
In rats?
Now, unless you are a billionaire, you'll never ever get to use this, but...
maybe not.
You know.
Everything gets to the other people eventually.
Eventually, but this is something that may not. All right, so we got back on H. We got to head to H2 and scan. We don't need to do that. We need to approach the elevator at I6. This is where we were before, but when we got down the elevator, we couldn't break down the wall.
Ah. Alrighty then.
This place is giant. I can't wait to be done. I like this place, but. The music sounds epic, but hey, look, it's another party here. This looks like this is where people go to level.
Interesting.
So maybe when we decide to go job point hunting and spark hunting, we should go here.
Like, as much as I want to do that, I feel like that 119 weapon is not that good. I mean, it was better than one of the ones I have now. But my 117 weapon has like a higher damage and lower delay than my other weapons, so. And more accuracy, probably. So I don't understand.
Yeah, that's fair. I don't have enough, I just want the other one because it has higher accuracy, because considering accuracy seems to be the stat that fucks us over for content. Well, the other team here.
Other than health and just dying.
Yeah. Like that bomb. Actually, if I was full health, I would have survived that bomb.
Today, I finally got enough health to survive getting crit by, the line AoE attack that Diablos does in Scathe. I survived with like 200, like 100 HP.
Ah! Excellent.
I was like, I'm alive! And you know it's good when like your caster has something and you're not dead.
So my brother's... Yeah. So my brother, he's been playing FF14, as you know, but for some reason he likes to just log out of the game without actually logging out.
Is this Alt-F4s inside a dungeon? Yeah.
It seems like it, because he's the only one. He's like, I don't do that. I log out normally. And I'm like, why are you the only person who ever gets locked in dungeons for, like, weeks? Anyway, he has been really enjoying the story, but he's not geared enough to continue on. So, I have been talking to him, and I can't wait for him. Like, he just recently did Aether Chemical Research Facility, and... nuclear reactor or whatever.
Anime Gamer doesn't like to hide and attack mobs inside of rooms like we do. Anime Gamer just stands and fights.
We play WoW a lot. But I want him to get to the later parts of the story because, or at least geared enough to do Dun Skate because. He's a huge fan of Dragon Ball Z, and I think he'd like it.
Oh, the... yeah.
So, Kittens, now that you're here, how is school going? You said you were doing the pilot exam for English. How did that go? I always wanted to go get my pilot license in real life. In fact, I want to get my pilot license primarily because I think it'd be funny to get my license to fly a plane before I get my license to fly a car. Or fly a car. Drive a car.
Fly a car.
One day I will fly a car.
I'm paralyzed, that's why I can't.
I still want self-driving cars to be a master's thing so that I don't have to go and get my license. I'm too lazy to do that.
Yeah.
Mind you, I can drive a car. I took driver's ed. I passed their fucking mock driver's test. It's just when I went to go do it, my car broke down and nobody wanted to help me fix it. I was in college and couldn't afford it.
Oh.
So, since then, my car died and I was like, fuck it, I don't care. I don't need one. I work from home. And only a car in Ontario nowadays is really just too expensive. And then you have our leaders who are like, we're going to cut off 25% of your phone bill, but add this tax that adds 25%. It's like, why? This isn't a good thing. She couldn't finish. How come? I think my music might be too loud. How's my voice compared to the music, Silky? I think this might be a dead end, but I'm not sure. Yeah, it's dead end. Alright, we're gonna go around the long way.
Damn. Alright.
This game makes us take the long way. Right, so I already killed everything in the center of the room, so.
Yeah. Also, the items that I have equipped now are better than what I had before, but they also, some of them buff my healing too, so that's helpful.
Yeah.
A little bit, anyway.
There's some roots here, but we don't need to go down those. We're gonna bypass these. We gotta go to the elevator. Making sure we're going the right way. So my computer still hasn't arrived. Music's a little loud. Okay, give me a second. I gotta turn it down.
No, turn it up.
There you go. Turn it down a little. My computer chair still has not arrived, so I'm still using my couch as a computer chair. And streaming and playing games is not exactly easy on it, but I've managed to work it out so far.
Pretty serious.
I'm not looking forward to raiding like this, though.
Hmm.
That's gonna be a pain.
So you, like, drag your couch over to your computer desk, basically?
Yep.
Oh, boy.
And then I pile pillows on it and sit on the pillows.
Oh, God. So what happened to, like, a regular chair?
I don't own any other chairs other than my computer chair and my couch.
Ah.
This is kind of, like, a drive to get me to own new computer stuff, I guess.
I guess so.
To own new stuff? I should have bought a Lazy Boy back when I had the time and the money.
Yeah, but the Lazy Boy wouldn't be any better, I don't think.
Not as crazy as you'd like to be, so it took 2-3 hours to figure out a topic. So when I was in high school, in grade 12 English, they made us write these essays, comparative essays, subjective essays, and some other type. Anyway, but they said that the topics that they gave us for it to write the essays, they actually gave us topics we had to write on, were all topics that we had written on earlier in the year. The very same thing. And I had a feeling that she was going to do that, so I went home and memorized the three essays that she had us write earlier in the year, and just rewrote them on the exam. Word for word. Because I have a fairly decent memory. And she marks it. She's like, wow, these are fantastic essays. The same thing she wrote on the other essays that I wrote. And I went back to see a friend the next year, and I saw her, and I pointed out to her that she probably shouldn't do that. And she's like, why? And I'm like, because I've literally just memorized my essays and put them on the test. Like, and she's like, well, that requires you to know that that's what I'm going to do. And I'm like, well, I had a strong suspicion, so, and I took it. She said, fair enough. And she's like, you know, the average student isn't going to be able to memorize three essays.
Yeah, right.
And then, having a good memory has worked out really well for me, too, because in college, for one of my border classes, I had to do an essay on Cabasus centralis. Cabasus centralis is the naked-tailed armadillo. And, okay, so where are we going? Hang on one sec. We are going down at C8. That is. We gotta head over to. Hang on a sec. Okay, we're gonna break it at CF and head to the room at C8. And C8 is down there. Alright, I know where we're going. Anyway, so I had to do a presentation on Cabasus centralis. It had to be between 9 and 10 minutes. He was very strict about this. And mine was like 8 minutes and 40 something seconds. And he still gave me 100%. And I'm like, why did you do that? Because, you know, I was trying to be fair. And he's like, out of all the essays, yes, you were short by 20 seconds, or presentations, you were short by 20 seconds, but you were the only one who didn't look at your presentation at all.
Yep, he went that way.
And I was like, all right, I guess that's fair. And he's like, so in my books, that makes up for,
I brought a friend.
Is it an anime gamer?
No.
Oh,
but I didn't realize that you had already appeared and, like, gone somewhere.
Okay. This guy's got a sight.
I just stood around and waited.
The concept of a sight is a really cool weapon, but in reality, it is not that cool of a weapon. I guess I am a cheat. I guess that's fair.
Your dagger looks pretty cool.
Well, that's trippy. Sorry about that. I don't know where Anime Gamer has gone. They've disappeared. They're fighting something. Well, maybe not. Their HP is not moving. Are they breaking down the wall? Nope, they're not breaking down the wall. I don't know where they went. We will tear down this wall.
Okay. Start on the wall.
Alright, I'll beat up these vengeful shun so they don't mess with us. I got 3,000 TP, but I'm not gonna use it on this guy. I'll use it on the next one. I noticed as we went along in the expansions, I stopped using a lot of my abilities, like Berserk and that. I suppose I should use them, but. But, like, apparently boost doesn't stack with, Oh, okay, Valor, just run right through that wall. Anyway, apparently Warcry doesn't stack with boost, so.
Huh.
What are your plans for tonight, Silky Kitten? Silly and I are gonna raid, we're gonna do A9S, and then hopefully we'll be able to beat hopefully we'll be able to beat Zervin. Very close. Still haven't gotten an X name for some X though. He's the only person I know that can fill in. Well, maybe Sab can come along, but I don't know if he's done any of the other Warn Triad.
I don't know. Watch we'll use the Fear Extreme and get me a Dark Knight and a Monk weapon. And Sabala. I may not hit as hard as you, but I hit faster.
That's true. But I don't think it's fast to a degree where you're like overtaking me like 2 hits per.
No.
There we go. We did it, team! You wanna play an MMORPG because you're tired of Fire Emblem? Yeah, I can understand that. I haven't picked up Fire Emblem again in a little bit, mostly because I've been playing the shit out of Zelda, which, by the way, I have one more area to uncover. But the area I'm currently in is extremely mountainous and requires a lot more finesse than I have. No, it's very mountainous, so it takes me a while. Like, I run over every part of the map and try to look for everything. Obviously, there's stuff I miss still, but because this game is ridiculous. But I try to grab everything I can. And, yeah, I have a lot of weapon slots now because of that.
Excellent. My favorite thing in that game is jumping on your shield and riding it.
I don't know if there's anything wrong with that. Sometimes family can be very annoying. I don't get along with any of my cousins, so I don't blame you for that. Probably gonna get a Destella hand. Yeah. Just gonna drag it over here, though. Yeah, hit me for 80 damage. That's cool. What is this? Outside, wrong side of the room. Okay. Where did Anime Gamer go? Oh, they're up there. Okay, there they go. See you later. Ah, your shark bite did 1,309 damage. Good job.
Yeah.
Mine did more than that.
I know.
Well, I think Anime Gamer's fighting something. Let's go help them.
Let him die.
If it's got a skull on it, it's probably gonna have ice spikes on it. So what don't you like about your cousin?
Am I not attacking? Let's play.
What is my other chat? There it is. Alright. They both just die at the same time. Alright.
Yeah, Valinor will skill chain something.
That works. Alright, we're gonna probably have to fight maybe one of these double hands if. Oh, he turned around. Alright. Unless he turns around again. Which he might. Hey, did we get through? We did! We're the best. Okay, we're gonna have to take that down here, I think, in a moment. On an architrave. Alright, so this is, I'm pretty sure, where we have to go. Let me check just to be sure. Yes, this is gonna take us into D8. There you go. Cutscene.
Cutscene. Oh. I wanna be slow in the cutscene because I was invisible.
Alright. Got the. Alright, so it's returned to Mount Camier. So we're gonna use our ring. As long as you've clicked that door and gotten the sun-kissed scale, that should be it. So we're gonna use our warp bang.
You got it.
Oh, I can understand why you wouldn't want to be around her. Sounds rude. I'm gonna move the chat on my stream to the other side of my screen. Okay, that should be better. Sorry, I'm still optimizing how my stream looks for people, but so it looks better. It's taking me a bit, so. Well, I don't know about that. I'm gonna get Ionis cast on me, silly.
Oh, yes. Mine ran off earlier.
Oh, there's booger balls! Come on, booger balls. Hi, Cat. What are you doing? It's a booger balls, not Bailey. The moment I said that, she jumps up. What? Now that the couch is over here, she's like, oh, I'm just gonna be all over you during stream time. Oh, she wants to lay on the footstool. Okay.
Do we go back to Camier? Or...
Yeah, we're going back to Mount Camier, but I had to, go here first. I think we can use the home point to get close by, though, so... The home point was close enough that we could just mount all the way there. Oh, that's right, spring break!
What's spring break?
I don't know, it's not something that I get at work anymore, so... So we gotta go to... Camera drifts. Point one. My cat has made herself comfortable on the footstool. Alright, so this should be right near where we need to go. I'll let you know in a moment once I'm allowed to have a map. Yeah, it is. Okay. So now we'll mount up. Oops. It's cold here, so we're gonna ride the war machine. Very happy that they turned this into a mount. I still fail to see how this functions as a war machine, but... Considering a cannonball would tear through this, swords would... and axes and shit would hack this to pieces. But I guess... I don't even know how this actually picks up any actual velocity either, so... You know what else I like about FF11's mounts?
What?
That when they turn on mounting in a zone, you can mount literally anywhere in that zone.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't develop a system like in FF14 where you run through a cave and it dismounts you.
That's true. They probably don't have the sophistication for something like that.
They probably do, but don't know how to put it into FF11's unsophisticated code.
That's what I mean. It's like, they can't figure out how to put it into Final Fantasy XI, so they just didn't bother. They just set the flag to your mount on.
Yeah, exactly. Like, we weren't intending to give you mounts anyway, so whatever. Alright, Silly, you ready?
Yeah.
Let me check my recording. Let me reset it before we click this.